too. You know, so you know, to have all the miscues that we, and also had those guys bagged up to the 5 yard line, and they ran a 95 yard touchdown on like a third down and like 35. You know, so you know, we lacked a little bit of focus during the course of that game, but you know, we had enough firepower to endure, and I was just happy that we were able to pull the win off.
Now, talk to me about your quarterback, Kevon Taylor. Had a heck of a game in last week's game, 17-27, for 247 yards and two touchdowns. 6'5" senior. Talk to us about him, Coach.
Well, Kevon is a guy that came in a couple of years ago as a highly touted Division I transfer via junior college. And we've always had high expectations for him. And, you know, I made it clear to the coaching staff, I made it clear to the rest of the team that, you know, we were going to run an offense that was going to be catered to his skill set. He has a ton of athletic ability. And, you know, I was just glad to see him make SIAC Player of the Week despite the interceptions that he threw, because two of them that he threw bounced right out of the hands of the receivers and went right into the hands of the defenders. And so I was just happy to see that kid get justice.
All right. Well, speaking of justice being served, you got a big-time matchup, SIAC matchup, against Miles College. They come into this game 1-2. They've actually lost to some very formidable opponents in West Georgia, who just competed for that Division II championship a couple years ago, last year, 2 years ago, and then against the SWAC's Alcorn State University, who they are the reigning East champs out of the SWAC 3 years in a row. So what do you see when you look at Miles College versus your team on tape?
Well, I mean, every year, you know, we kind of been around the block a little bit. You know, Miles always gets off to a slow start just because of their strength of schedule. But make no bones about it now. Make no bones about it. They're one of the top resource football teams in our conference. They got one of the top coaches in our conference. They got a president over there that wants to win football games. And whenever you have those things, you know, you win. So, you know, they're going to come in well coached, with really good players, really strong defensive and kicking game and systematic approach as far as running the football offensively. So it's a well-coached team. It'll be in a hostile environment. And, you know, we're going to find out what type of team we have. And I'm pretty sure their coach feels the same way.
Yeah, absolutely. This is the HBCU Report. Rob Calloway on the line with Rich Freeman, head football coach of the Morehouse Maroon Tigers. They are in action later today versus Miles College, the Golden Bears. 6 o'clock Eastern kickoff, 5 o'clock Central kickoff. It is the Prince Hall Americanism Football Classic going down in Fairfield, Alabama. Now, a couple things I want to talk to you about outside of football. You know, of course, you're there at one of the more storied HBCUs and you know, and all of the nation. And so what's going on right now? You talked about Miles College administration, and we know that President French has done some great things down there to help their athletic department. What's going on right now with the administration? Because I know y'all have had, you know, unexpected death and some other things that have happened. So what's going on at Morehouse in that regards?
Well, first and foremost, our president right now, interim president Martin, we're very happy with him. He's definitely hit the ground running, and he's done some monumental things to keep us in stride over here. And he's come and approached me on several occasions about athletics. So he has a lot of fire and a lot of energy, and we're following him at this point. You know, I do know that, you know, we have a national search on for a new president, and we're going to let that take its course. But right now, we're in good hands with President Martin.
Okay, good stuff. Always, you know, because it's one of those things where, again, you know, the administration, and me and you have talked about this, like the athletic department is only going to be as strong as the relationship with the administration. So,
question about it.
You know, and the thing about it is you guys been, you know, putting out a quality product, you know, year in and year out, basketball too. So, you know, just, you know, I know it's from a coaching standpoint, it'll be a relief once all of the dust is settled and whether the interim becomes the head or whatever happens.
No question about it.
All right. So a couple other things, Coach. You know, I feel like, a lot of times we have conversations and you bring a lot of perspective to the conversation. And, this week in football news, we found out in reports are saying that Aaron Hernandez actually was suffering from the worst case of CTE they've ever seen for somebody at his age. We know that football is a collision sport. We know it's a very violent sport. But what are some of the things like from the time you began coaching to this point? What are some of the things that you've seen, some of the steps that you've seen being taken in order to kind of protect these players from themselves?
Well, I think, it's nothing new under the sun, first and foremost. You know, it's been a problem with health in football ever since the sport, originated. So, I just think that, transparency now, because we're in the information age and, we've been able to get information and pass on and try to see if we can put parameters in place to try to prevent. So I think that's just the stage that we're in. And I think that as coaches, as players, I think the awareness is something that we need to take heed, and try to make a difference, with the way we practice, with the way we approach our offensive game plans, defensive game plans, kicking game plans, with the way we substitute players, so on and so forth. It's definitely something that we all need to stop and take a strong look at.
Absolutely. Now, before I let you go, Coach, looking at your schedule, man, this thing is not going to get easy for you, man. Looking at the schedule coming up after today's game, you got Kentucky State, you got the Tuskegee Morehouse Classic, you got Albany State, you got Benedict, who's on the upswing with Coach Mike White up there. You got Fort Valley, and then you close the season out with Clark Atlanta. So from that standpoint, what are your thoughts on this season of SIAC action?
Hey, we knew the schedule before we started playing it, and it's definitely a tough one. And I don't think we have a bad team in the conference this year. I think every team is good. A lot of people, thought that, that was going to be a cakewalk for us last week with Central State. But Central State has one of the best quarterbacks in the conference. And you'll find that out as the season progresses. I'll be the first one to make that statement. So it's a lot of good football teams in our conference. And I believe we're one of them. So just like we have some of those games on our schedules, conversely, some of those teams have us on their schedules as well. So we're looking forward to it. We're going to take it 1 week at a time. This game will let us know exactly where we are as far as being a champion in our football conference. But it's also a meaningless game in terms of the Eastern Division, which is, in my opinion, the toughest division in the conference.
You're right about that. He is Rich Freeman, head football coach of the Morehouse Maroon Tigers. They're in action today versus Reginald Ruffins, Miles College Golden Bears, 5 o'clock Central, 6 o'clock in the East, from Fairfield, Alabama, Sloan Alumni Stadium. It is the Prince Hall Americanism Football Classic. Coach, thank you so much for joining us on the show, and we look forward to talking to you later in the season.
Hey, you bet. Thanks a lot.
All right, folks. Well, that about do it for another edition of the HBCU Report. Big shouts out to our guests for the week, Reginald Ruffin, Cedric Oglesby, and Coach Rich Freeman. Freeman and Ruffin, head-on collision today, 5 o'clock in the Central, 6 o'clock in the East, Morehouse versus Miles College. A couple other games of note for this weekend. You've got Bethune-Cookman at Howard, Clark Atlanta at Lane, Norfolk State and Delaware State hookup. Alabama A&M hosts Texas Southern. Winston-Salem State travels to Virginia State. North Carolina A&T takes on Morgan State. And my beloved Bama State, oh, mother dear, again, we come to thee, host Prairie View A&M at Bama State Stadium. All right, so, again, like to thank all you guys, all you new listeners, all you regular weekend listeners like to thank you for tuning into the HBCU Report, because again, without you, there would be no HBCU Report. Shouts out to the Two Live Stews. We got this thing popping, man. The Two Live Stews Radio Network. Hey, we're about to take this thing to a whole nother level. Please believe that. Don't forget, again, follow us on social media, Twitter and Instagram at HBCU Report. I am Rob Calloway, and this has been another edition of the HBCU Report.
It's the HBCU Report with Rob Calloway.